Hey guys, it's Rahul here from TechReview Pro, and in today's video you will learn how to prepare your iPhone for iOS 18 update the right way. Watching this video is very important so that you may avoid any big errors like the widescreen update or the green screen update error while updating. So without any further delay, let's get started. The first thing you need to consider before updating your iPhone to iOS 18 is considering checking space on your iPhone, as the iOS 18 update comes with at least 7 to 8GB of update. So if your iPhone is low on space, the update might not even download and install. So you need to free up your iPhone space to at least 10GB so that the iOS 18 update can be installed on your iPhone without any problem. If your device is running out of space or your iPhone's data storage space is full, you can erase all the unnecessary files, photos, videos, etc. to free up space on your device. You can delete and remove even the applications that you had installed previously but you are no longer using or haven't used recently. If you want to check out your iPhone storage, simply go to Settings and after that tap on General. And this will take you to General Settings. From here, select the iPhone storage. In this section, you'll get to know all the details about the apps and the files that are consuming your iPhone data and space, including how much your iPhone storage is being consumed by each of them. Apart from that, you can also enable settings which says offload unused apps. That will help you release your iPhone space for the iOS 18 update. The feature named offload unused apps simply deletes or uninstalls those applications from your iPhone that you have not been using for quite some time recently. And don't worry, all your data still remains saved, so you may always tap on install again without losing your data. Thus, offloading unused apps on your iPhone will free up the space on your iPhone so that you may smoothly download and install iOS 18 update on your iPhone. The next thing you need to consider before updating your iPhone to iOS 18 is ensuring that you have charged your iPhone completely. Even if it's not fully charged, at least try charging it to 80%, because while updating iOS 18, it'll need more battery power to install the updates and hence it may consume the battery power of your device quickly. If your iPhone is not charged, your device battery may die soon and the update might get stuck in the process. Why? It's because during the iOS 18 update process, your iPhone will shut down and restart multiple times. So if your iPhone battery is not sufficiently charged, the process will stop in the middle and that might cause data loss on your iPhone. If the update gets stuck in the middle, you will need to restore your iPhone using the iTunes or Finder app, and this will erase all the data of your iPhone. Therefore, make sure that you have fully charged your iPhone before updating to iOS 18, because it's mandatory to have enough battery juice to keep the update process running until it's completed. And the third and most important thing you can do before updating your iPhone to iOS 18 or any other iOS versions is to backup your iPhone. This is necessary because when you update your iPhone, maybe something doesn't work properly or something may create some problems after updating to the new iOS version. So in that case, if you want to roll back to the previous version of iOS or get back to iOS 17 on your iPhone, having the backup of all your data will be a lifesaver for you. So make sure you backup your iPhone by going to Settings and after that, tap on the Apple account or Apple ID option. And from here, select iCloud. Now tap on iCloud backup and enable this option to backup your iPhone. If you don't have sufficient iCloud storage to backup your iPhone, you can go to iPhone settings and after that, tap on General. Now from here, scroll down and select the option that says reset your iPhone. After that, select the option that says prepare for new iPhone. This is a free method to achieve unlimited iCloud data storage so that you can backup all of your files. And by the way, after 21 days, that data stored in the unlimited free iCloud data center will be deleted. But that shouldn't be an issue as you already have at least 21 days to recover all of your data just in case if you are facing any problem or want to roll back to the previous version. If backing up to iCloud is not something you prefer, maybe because of data charges, then you have also got the option to backup your iPhone by using iTunes on PC or Finder on Mac. If you don't have any idea how to back it up on your PC or MacBook, then I have already created a video about that. So make sure to tap here to watch that video.